Hello, this is Chad with Syncfusion. In this video, I'm going to take a very quick tour overview of our Gantt control for JavaScript. Here is the product page, and this is actually named the Gantt Chart. That's the actual name. This control is built in, is written in TypeScript, and it's built out to the variety of platforms you see here. It is designed to show project information. So if you want to display something for your customers to see or simply keep track of yourself, the Gantt control is here for you. This is a bunch of words talking about why the Gantt chart is awesome and why you should use it. And I'm gonna put all these pages that I show are gonna be in, there's gonna be links across the top of this video as we go along. But I'm gonna go now and jump into our samples. And here we are. This is the overview sample. And there's some things going on over here for me to talk about really quickly. If you look, you see the grid portion on the left and the chart portion on the right. The grid portion, we have a couple options. First, we have a column menu. This is a column menu here to let you edit the columns or filter, sort, and such, and even hide columns if you don't want to see them. Then we have each column, and these have column templates. So if I step into the source code for this, you can see the template is set up here in the HTML. We have 1, 2, and 3 different templates set up. They're fairly simple, just divs with some details. If we go look at the code part of this and scroll down to where the columns are defined, each column is simply given a template parameter. And that's it's as easy as that. This control, we allow editing in the here we go. We allow editing over here. So if you want to take this task and move it around, you can do just like that with it. And there it goes. We support virtual scrolling. If you have a ton of data, this comes in handy. Virtual scrolling works like this. There it is. We have a work week. You can define the work week to be viewed. So if you have a 5-day work week, this particular Gantt is working on 5 days. If I decide we want to have 4-day weekends every week, you can see the schedule expand. We support holidays. You can define your holidays. They show up like this as non-working days. We have a critical path. So the critical path is here in this particular Gantt. We support baseline. It looks like this. We support event markers, which are over here, and you can define these wherever you want, so you can talk about the project as you're going along. Column templates we talked about. Resource allocation. You can put at the end of each taskbar, you can show what resources are assigned and their usage percentage. You can also show this in a resource view. So here we have Martin is doing these jobs, and Rose, it looks like, is overbooked over here. We also have templates. So if you want to customize a taskbar to have a different view, it'll be the same, similar JavaScript template to what the column was. You can have a taskbar label template. So these are the labels for that particular taskbar. You can make them nice and pretty, just like this one is. You can do a toolbar template, tooltip rather, template. So I can take the tooltip and make it pretty. And of course, across the top, you can put a toolbar. This lightly blue bit here is a toolbar. We've added a couple extra things. Now, each of these samples has some text at the bottom describing what we did and how we did it. And if you look up here, I showed you the source tab. There's also an API tab that will show you all the API calls, the Gantt API calls that we made to create this sample. And these are links going directly to the documentation, the actual API documentation for each of these. And then over here on the right, this is edit in StackBlitz, meaning you can take this sample, it'll pull up in a StackBlitz window, and you can have a play right then and there. We support row, drag, and drop. So maybe I want to take this demand analysis, for example, and put it under defining the product. And there it is. We support splitting the task. So here's a task that's split across different regions, different times. This is a double split task, if you will. We support grid lines. So you can make it look like this, or you can make it a little bit prettier. Now, if you have Microsoft Project as your data source and you need to show that, don't fear. We have a nice little blog post showing you exactly how you can use our Syncfusion Gantt to display the Microsoft Project data. Okay, so that was a quick roll through of our JavaScript Gantt chart from Syncfusion. It's available in NPM and NuGet. Go download it to your project, have a play, let us know what you think. If you want those pop-up messages to disappear, you can come back here and claim a free trial. That'll give you a license key, put it in your app, and they go away. Thank you very much for watching.